Hi guys, welcome to K2N Family Channel. Today we're going to introduce to you to one of the most common and signature snacks prepared in Goa, commonly known as beef croquette. I'm using a special ingredient to this snack so that it's going to deliver an extra texture, a beautiful flavor out of it. Guys, stay tuned, watch the whole video and make sure that whenever you have any occasion in your houses, but you can prepare it and you can serve it very happily. So guys, let's go and prepare it. Till then,
so guys, to do the beef croquette, I'm using 1 kg of beef mince. You can use pork, chicken or beef, or you can mix a combination of anything you want like to. I've used 4 onions for 1 kg of beef, and I've finely chopped it. 2 medium potatoes, 2 tomatoes. I've got very small chilies, so I'm using only 5 of them because I like a little bit spicy. You can use according to your choice. About 3 inches of cinnamon stick, cloves, about 7 to 10, chorizos or sausages. I'm using combination of Goan sausages and chorizos as well. If you don't have Goan sausages, you just can use chorizos or here, normal. Then you've got chili powder, salt, egg, Maggi or stock if you have, coriander, turmeric, ginger garlic paste for marination, Goan vinegar, or I'm using, because I haven't gotten Goan vinegar, I'm using apple cider vinegar, breadcrumb, and finally semolina, and you need some oil for that.
So guys, I have already washed the meat completely and made sure that the water is completely drained off from the meat, so it's completely dry and everything. Now we are going to start with the marination. Use salt, chili powder, turmeric powder, and 1/2 cup of vinegar. And finally, we have about 3 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste. Now mix all this very well together and see that the whole meat is well marinated, and leave it aside for about like 30 minutes.
So guys, use about 4 to 5 teaspoons of oil. Once the oil is heated, add the cinnamon sticks and the cloves to roast. Once roasted, I'm going to use the onion that I've finely chopped. And saute well till it's mediumly done. Once the onion is mediumly done, I'm using the finely chopped tomatoes. Only it's worth 2 quantities of tomatoes that I've used. Saute again. I'm using a little bit more oil. If you anytime you feel like okay, the oil is not enough, it's getting dry, if you want to use oil, you can use it. So I've used a little bit more for myself. Now I'm using 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1 teaspoon of chili powder, and I'm going to mix it well as I'm sauteing this. I'm adding the chilies that I had with me. And along, I'm using the mixed sausages, Goan and sausages and chorizo that I've got. And again, here we go. We saute and fry this all together. 3 Maggis. You can use Goan chicken Maggis that you get, or normal Maggis that you get. So this is perfectly fried and done. So I'm using 1 cup of water in this. And then I'm going to use the meat that I marinated. Mix all well together. See that all your meat is been well mixed together. Whatever that you have sauteed, try to use as much as less water, because if you have a lot of water, then the meat goes really soft. You don't want that to happen. Once done, I'm going to use the potatoes that I've got and mix it again. And then I'm going to put the coriander.
mix it. Cover the lid and let it get cooked for about 20 to 25 minutes.
Yeah, it looks like the mince is already been cooked. Let's check.
You see everything, the water is completely dry. The potatoes are also done.
Good.
So I will put off the gas now and leave it to get cool. So guys, the mince is completely dry now. And what we are going to do, we are going to blend it now.
Okay, so we are going to take small portions. We put it in a mixer and we'll blend it all together to a fine paste.
Guys, once the paste is done, this is how it's going to be like. And we're going to take this all in one bowl now.
So guys, once you have bought all the meat in the bowl, I'm adding one egg to it. And mix well together. See that you mix everything very well. Mix the egg very well. And now I'm going to use breadcrumb. About 100 grams of breadcrumbs. Mix this very well thoroughly. Make sure that all the breadcrumbs and the meat is well marinated together. It blends very well. And once everything is mixed well, this is how it's going to be. And everything is ready. Now we're going to form the shape of croquette to fry.
We're going to start to make the form of a croquette. Take a small portion, roll it. I like make this size. Semolina, just roll it on top. It's ready. Make the portion, keep it ready.
So guys, this is the croquette, what I made it ready to fry. And I've kept the pan with oil. It's completely hot. Now I'm going to leave the croquettes inside to get deep fried.
Okay guys, so the croquettes are fried nicely. And just remember, you don't need to fry for too really long time. It's just the semolina that needs to be fried.
So guys, this is the croquettes what I've cooked now. This I already fried and it's ready to eat. So guys, I hope you also going to cook for yourself and enjoy it. I have rest to cook now. See you later. Adios. We'll be right back.